power of truth. What's it worth? Inspired by an Eddie Bravo podcast on the theory of the flat earth. And I'm gonna side with Eddie Bravo and just say, I don't know. And just check out that podcast or that video on YouTube. It's got one of the Gracie family members on there too. But what the fuck was his name? I think it was the son of Hicks and Gracie. But I forget the name. Chrome Gracie. And he was saying that he thinks of something beyond jiu-jitsu, beyond MMA, beyond his family name, which is truth. And I like that a lot, because I think a lot of motherfuckers will say, you know what, I'm going to leave a legacy behind. I'm going to leave this Winchell's donut. Are they still on Winchell's? The Yum Yum buy them out. I'm going to leave this donut shop, this restaurant, this business behind, this trust fund. And good on you, mate, if you're going to create a fortune or a comfortable nest egg for your kids, grandkids, for your own good. Because I think that if, generally speaking, if families took care of each other, then the family would be strong, the house would be strong, the apartment complex would be strong, the block would be strong, the neighborhood would be strong, the community, the city, the state, the nation, the empire, civilization. And again, from my travels, my life experience, now it does. It bothers me enough that I keep on mentioning it, video after video, of seeing people or people just seeing this as simply just a pencil made in Germany. Why can't you pick it up? Why can't you get some copy paper and just zigzag? See where the leaves are going to fall for the edge of the design. Maybe you fucked up. Maybe it's good. Maybe if you fucked up, you could get over it. Work with it. Grow from it, or acknowledge your ignorance. How will I fix this? Find a solution for making this edge with the leaf look natural. There was a point in time in my tattoo career where I was at a tattoo shop, and I believe the design requested by a walk-in client was, I want the Libra symbol tattooed on me. And I'm there, like, sketching it out, like, thinking, oh, does it look like this? I need to, maybe the edge is like that, or and that's what I'm thinking in my head. You know, it looks like it's gotta be perfect the first time instead of just going with the flow, working with it, clearing it up, darkening it up as I progress. And eventually something will pop out. But she could tell that I was struggling, and I was. And one of the other tattooers came along and said, "Hey, could I help you?" I was like, "Yeah, I want to get a Libra tattoo design, but not from him because he can't draw." And I thought, fucking bitch. Then I thought, why does it sound? Why does it feel true? Why am I not offended as it being a lie? Because it wasn't. But maybe I got butthurt from the tact of it. The tact of her remark. But imagine if I would have said, "No, excuse me, lady. Excuse me, bitch. Fucking nigger, bitch. You know, my mommy says that I'm her king, and my teacher gave me this award in kindergarten, and that says that I could draw. Mm-hmm. I won this Crayola contest, this drawing contest, this finger painting contest in sixth grade. Mm-hmm. That means I could draw. I'm special. Or I got a degree from Schmuckatelli University. Clown College. That means I could draw. But it matters now, at the moment where your armor is tested, your abilities are measured, where you produce value to the market. But anyways, when I thought of that, I thought, wait a minute. This bitch is right, fucking bitch. But she's true, it's true. And I didn't like how that felt. So, if I didn't like how it feels, I could simply say, I quit. I'm not gonna do this. I'm just gonna flip burgers or mop floors. And no one's ever gonna critique me there, because I know how to mop floors and flip burgers. I could have gone that route. Or else I could have done what I done did, which is, it's true that I can't draw fluently, whatever fucking word is correct there. How do I unfuck that? How do I make that no longer true? Practice. Draw. Watch people draw. Watch people paint. Airbrush. Sculpt. Sketch. Alright, enough of that, and now it's just this, just doing this. And as you see that I'm talking shit, as I'm talking shit, I'm not thinking 1000% here. Oh, you know what, the leaf, it's under this layer, and I should put it over here, and that, and something beautiful, and people are gonna buy it, and I'm gonna keep talking like this to them, and you know, it wouldn't be good. I'm gonna go with the flow. If it looks dicked up, well then, got my eraser here. Erase the parts I don't like, keep what I do like. For the moment, roll with it. And I've done that for thousands of hours, and it's gotten me to this level here where I could walk and chew bubblegum, talk shit, and figure things out at the same time. You know, but what truth? And I'm gonna put the guilt trip on you. because not just in drawing, but in other parts of my life, I've said, where am I not being completely effective, completely good, completely focused, completely driven, completely in the moment? Because I think that when you finally say, I'm going to be a better illustrator, a better ballerina, a better weightlifter, a better painter, a better landscaper, a better toilet scrubber, a better... Let me think of something new. A better bricklayer. A better tire fixer. Whatever, mechanic. You know, why do my customers not come back? Why do my girlfriends always break up with me? Why do my boyfriends break up with me? Why did I get a divorce? Why did that fail? Why did I get an F on the test? Why didn't I complete the task? Make this or that happen? Why? And I think when you... I don't know what the fuck's going on here. Erase it because I'm confused. I think when you search for the truth, they be like, man, where am I fucking up? Where am I lacking? I think when you calculate that, when you find out that you're not a prince, a king, the little princess, perfect, that you're just as fucked up and just as capable as a retard and a champion. I think with that calculation, that admission or that realization that you can grow from there, man. So what's the truth for you? What value could it have for you? What could it do for you? So get after it, motherfuckers. As Fox Mulder would say, the truth is out. The truth is out there. X-Files. Trump 2020.